My dream destination are Hungary. Today I'll tell you why I choose Hungary as my dream destination. Hungary has a lot to impress me, but first I will start with the history of Hungary. The territory that is now Hungary was a part of the Roman Empire until its fall in the 4th century, when it was taken over by the strong Huns. Following that, a succession of a lesser Middle European empires went through until the Magyar tribes created and united federation in the 9th century. During the following 100 years, Christianity spread throughout Hungary and Catholic Apostolic Kingdom was ruled by the first Hungarian monarch, subsequently beatified as Saint Stephen. After a brief conflict in the early 12th century, the kingdom was reunited with Croatia and King Andrew II led a massive royal army to the Holy Land as a part of the Fifth Crusade in 1217. His reign was shattered 35 years later by a Mongol invasion, which killed 20% of the population. After they withdrew, the area, like the rest of the medieval Central Europe, was engulfed in decades of conflict, including unsuccessful Ottoman invasions. In late 1944, Soviet soldiers entered Hungary, discovering a shattered nation with a decimated population. It remained a Soviet communist stronghold until the 1989 revolt, which led Mikhail Gorbachev to agree to Premier Kremlin Gross demands. In 1990, free elections were held and Soviet soldiers eventually left in 1991. The hard-won independence of Hungary opened the way for the fall of the Berlin Wall, the end of the Soviet period and the conclusion of the Cold War. Next, I will tell you about the interesting culture that is in Hungary. Hungary's rich culture is rich in folk traditions and its own unique style, which has been influenced by many ethnic groups, notably the Roma. Music of various types, from classical to folk, as well as the country's rich literary history, play a vital role in the daily life. Ceramics and needlework, Hungary's distinct traditional cuisine, powerful fruit bandies, dancing, and the ever-popular spa treatment are examples of the country's rich past. Hungary's 10 million inhabitants are energetic, sociable, and place a high importance on family, with generations living in the same house under one roof and grandparents having a major influence in their grandchildren's upbringing. Due to their old nomadic heritage, Hungarians are a nation of horsemen and visitors are frequently invited to go horseback riding with their new local acquaintance. Personal inquiries about your life are all a part of getting to know process here, and hospitality is a big element of the culture. There are many sights to enjoy while staying at Hungary, such as Buda Castle, Budapest. Once you've seen the magnificent Buda Castle in Budapest, Hungary's capital, you'll understand why this city is known as the Paris of the East. In terms of magnificent dimensions and superb architecture, this remarkable historic relic, now a UNESCO World Heritage Site, stands right up there with Versailles in France. This latter edifice, erected on the site of a palace destroyed during the Ottoman Empire siege of 1686, was rebuilt in the 18th century for the Habsburg monarchy and has more than 200 rooms. Its symmetrically arrangement centers on the magnificent 61-meter high central dome facing the Danube, from which you can obtain stunning views of the castle and other castle hills building, the Buda Hills. The Buda Hills, located on the western suburbs of Budapest, rise to a height of more than 580 meters and are crisscrossed by a vast network of hiking and bike routes. Bicycle rental establishments may be located all around the city. You may also take the tram to the Kaut Railway Terminal, which leads to the charming residential area of Széchenyi Hegyi. The narrow Kaut Children's Railway takes a beautiful path to Hovasvölgy from here. There are also a lot of walking paths from every station, or you may get off at Jenőhegyi, the highest stop, and take the Budapest Care lift down for some of the best views in the city. Sopron, a historic city, is worth visiting. Location near the eastern foothills of the Alps, roughly 60 km south of Vienna and 8 km from the Austrian border, and it's a popular day trip destination. Its attraction derived from both its beautiful surroundings and its numerous well-preserved medieval and baroque structures. Sopron has 240 protected buildings, 115 of which are legally designed monuments, making it one of Europe's biggest collection of its kind. All of the structures in the old town are contained within the medieval town wall, which was erected on Roman remains. cave of Lilafred. Another famous spa site in Hungary is Lilafred in the Bug Mountains. It's also known for its several beautiful caverns, all of which are within walking distance of the town. The Isvan cave with a spectacular stalactite formations and the petrified cave recognized the world over the imprints of extinct plant species left in its limestone wall are two of the most intriguing to explore. Tihany is a favorite tourist spot on Lake Balaton. This small peninsula, which was formerly an island, comprised just 8 square kilometers, yet has some of Hungary's most spectacular landscape. The southern portion, which has been designated as a natural reserve, is restricted to vehicles and is ideal for exploring on foot along the well-marked trail network. The magnificent 17th century Benedictine Abbey, with a spectacular views of the lake and surroundings, is a must-see landmark in the town itself. It's especially lovely in the early spring when the almond trees in the area are in blossom, and in June when the scent of lavender fills the air. I'll go to Budapest Airport, Hungary from Kuala Lumpur International Airport by Turkish Airlines with a price of RM2,400 round trip, and stay at Eaton's guest house for 1 week with the price RM1,420. Then I'll take a rental car to travel around Hungary because it is easier for me to go anywhere without following a fixed schedule. To go to purpose places, the estimated price is 985 ringgit by using rental cars and